Hello there, this is The Handshake. I'm Lynn Combisher, and with me is Edna Ruth Muriru. Edna, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Lynn.
We have seen an increase in digitalized, you know, economy. There's a lot going on the, you know, on the internet, selling of goods here and there, and services as well.
Yes.
But as we look at it, in Uganda, they say it is supposed to, it is posing a big potential for SMEs.
Yes.
For the small, medium, and medium enterprises, yes. Mm. How is this happening?
By being online, mm-hmm. you're exposed to the global economy, to yes. the global market.
Yes. Yes.
So the people who are saying this work with a courier service mm-hmm. and they transport goods all over the country. So they're saying that they're seeing a bigger growth in the number of people who are receiving orders online. Ugandan businesses that are receiving orders online and then they're transporting those goods to the rest of
the world.
Of the world.
Really?
Yes.
It's happening.
Yes, it is. It's interesting. When there are people doing different models, there are people mm-hmm. who are selling within the region mm-hmm. and these are, you know, like boutiques,
yeah.
small businesses that are supplying Uganda, Kenya and Tanzania.
Sure.
But they might have a store somewhere in Kampala, mm-hmm. but most of those orders are coming from their Facebook, from their Instagram, from their websites. Yes.
The way we see, the way, because I can order for, say, a pair of shoes or a dress,
yes.
and it has to come in from, say, Singapore or something.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
The same thing is happening with
the same thing is happening. We have many businesses that have entered that yeah. space and are playing in that area.
True.
And there are also people that are creating marketplaces both for specialized kinds of goods.
Mm-hmm.
For example, there is a lady who used to work here, then she relocated to the US.
Mm-hmm.
But what she did was create a network of people that supply African wear.
Okay.
African, like kente materials,
okay.
Tie and dye materials, mm-hmm. African crafts.
Yes.
So she created a marketplace
mm-hmm.
and that it took off because
really?
There's so many people, like when we get tourists here and they go back with some of these things, their
yeah,
friends want to know, where did you get this? But she's based in the US.
Mm-hmm.
She has created a marketplace for so many different businesses based in Uganda,
yes.
and in different parts of Africa.
That's amazing.
So by being online,
mm.
you are really talking to the rest of the world.
Is this where we're headed?
I think it's going to continue that way because
mm-hmm.
there are also other benefits of being online. You know, instead of having three stores, I can have one store
mm-hmm.
in one place, and then my presence online will push the business to a whole other level. You know, then you cut out the brick and mortar costs. You don't have
yeah.
rent. You have only the employees at that one store, then maybe packaging and shipping. So
sure.
there are costs that you cut by having
you
a good
presence.
You can
actually do it on your own.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, keep your things within your house. When
mm-hmm.
there's an order, you package properly, send.
Yes.
It's interesting.
Mm.
Well, so do people make money out of that? Or don't we have scams? Don't we find issues? What challenges are there?
I think the challenge would be on the customer's side
because
I haven't viewed the good that I am ordering. So
it's
only until I receive it that I know the quality.
And you know you're not allowed to, say, try on a dress and
sure
it fits properly.
Yes. So there are those challenges. But I think if you're dealing with a credible person,
mm-hmm.
they should be able to tell you. And that is the only way people can grow is if they are doing the right thing and selling the right product, not selling, you know, poor quality products
mm-hmm.
and passing them off as very good. So if the businesses want to grow, they will definitely put in the effort, make sure that we promise what we deliver is what we promised, you know,
sure.
and we can do refunds or give you a better product if there's a challenge with that.
Mm-hmm.
Like it's easy to swap
sure.
in case of challenges.
So what would you advise? Do you think it's a good area to go into?
I think it is, and there's no one model that works. There are people that have used online
mm-hmm.
to push their small businesses.
True, true.
And then they move in, they find a residence after that, they find a home for this business after they have pushed it online and they have enough orders to sustain,
mm-hmm.
you know. So I think we can play around with this.
Mm-hmm.
Being online is
manageable.
Really, it is, if you want to be seen, I think that is the place you have to be. You've got to be on the social media platforms. It would be good to have a website, you know. It would be nice for you to talk about your product in this space, because the audience is everyone who has an internet link. So.
And there are millions and millions.
Oh, yes.
Oh, I think I need to do a business online. I tried one, and maybe I was not serious, I think. But don't worry, I'm going to come back. Thank you so much, Edna.
Thank you, Lynn.